Alright, today we're gonna dig up this clump of daylilies here and separate them, clean out this little bed here. It's just starting to rot the wood, and we're gonna replace all this. Get these daylilies up and separate them. Now we got several fans. We can have several fans out of this. That's a good four or five right there. Just in this clump. New ones coming up too. We have a lot more daylilies here than I thought. Like I started separating all these things, there's a lot more here. Have any weed barriers, so we're gonna put down cardboard in here. We'll put down cardboard to keep these things from getting, keep the weeds out. Got all the cardboard down in place, hopefully. Now we got enough soil here to cover the ground. Cover the area we made. I'm just using topsoil for this. Ain't no needin', buy no expensive soil. More than enough. Cover the area we want to work on. Oh yeah, it's gonna be plenty. Plenty enough. These are some other daylilies I had around the front that I dug up. Didn't show them. Well, some of them kind of small. I have to leave them together as twos. So. A lot of these I'll just leave as they are. As they come up out of the ground, it'll be easier. I don't have to wait on them to. As long as waiting on them to get cut to recover from the shock. Maybe it'll take off a little bit faster. The clump I separated from the back was a lot larger than what this one is. So, what these are. This one I'll take apart in several small ones. That'd be good. These are all Stella de Oro purple day lilies. Later on, about a year after they grow good, you get a lot of seeds from these. I'll get seed pods from the others already. Later on this summer, and the ones we already have, I really don't know if these are gonna root in anything, grow in anything or not, but we'll plant these small ones out here too. And we'll have a lot more than what we make room for. Got this large clump right here. I'll separate in. Like from this small clump, we're probably gonna get about 30 out of just this right here. Cause all these little ones, and there are a lot of them. One clump of fans turned into 30, looks like. Not what I expected. A lot more than I really thought there would have been. Consider the size of that clump wasn't as large as the other one. So, I'll weed some of these together since I ain't got enough soil to expand this lot any larger than what it is. At least some of these as it is, and I can do these again later. This large clump that I had. Now what we're gonna do with this, I don't know. This is awful large. Big fans here. this one ain't wanting to come apart.
It usually will.
There, we got one big fan out of it. Put it right in here. We're gonna have to move some of these. There's gonna be, ain't gonna be enough room for all these big fans to be put in here. Need a little bit of room for them. Wish I could leave this as it is, plan it in. We'll have to dig it out, separate it later. It's so big. We're running out of space. All right. Now, hopefully, they'll grow good. We'll water them in a little bit. See what they do. Well, maybe in a few, about 6 months, we'll have some blooms on it and these large ones here and some seeds coming out in the fall. And we germinate them and grow some more. I guess that's it for this video. So, hope you like it, share, and subscribe. Thanks for watching.